Hello everyone, my name is Alexandra and I work at the Toronto Public Library, and I'm very excited to welcome you to Mini Makers at Home. Mini Makers is a library program where children and families explore STEM concepts together. STEM stands for science, technology, engineering, and math. And STEM is all around us, meaning we can use simple objects to do STEM from the comforts of our homes. Today, we will be making our very own itty bitty parachutes. But before we get into the activity, you might be wondering, what is a parachute anyway? You can think of a parachute like the fluff on a dandelion weed. The fluff actually contains seeds. When dandelions are blown into the air by the wind or by people, they fall slowly and softly to the ground to spread and plant their seeds. In a parachute, the air is forced inside the curve or wing at the top, so heavy objects and people can fall slowly to the ground without getting hurt. Parents and caregivers, you are your child's first and best teacher, so please take this opportunity to do the activity together. Now, are we ready to make our parachutes? Well, let's get started.
To make your parachute, you will need a napkin or tissue, 4 equal pieces of string or rope. If you don't have these, you can even use dental floss. Whatever tape you have on hand. Rulers are not necessary, but they do help you with measuring. A pair of scissors to cut the string or rope. And finally, a small object that is heavy for its size, like a key, a coin, or a little toy. Be creative with what you use. Start off by laying your napkin flat and measuring out a piece of string at around 30 centimeters or about a foot in length. You don't need a ruler for this. Mine was too small, so I experimented. Measuring is a great way to practice math, the M in STEM. Repeat the last step until you have 4 equal pieces of string. Next, cut 4 pieces of tape and attach each piece of string to the 4 outer corners of the napkin. Twist the loose pieces of string together and tie a knot around your object. This is a tricky part, so you can always ask an adult for help with this step, or even use tape instead. Your object is now ready for takeoff. When you're done making your parachute, pinch the middle of the top of the napkin and try throwing it into the air. Notice how even if you throw the parachute upside down, gravity draws the heavier object at the bottom of your parachute towards the ground, making for a nice and soft landing.
Now that you're done making your parachute, we challenge you to try throwing the parachute from different heights, like from the top of your couch, a chair, or the stairs. But don't forget safety. Be sure to ask for help from your adult when doing this.
Pretty soon, your parachute will be going on its own adventures.
When you're dropping the parachute, notice how it lands and think about how slowly or quickly it falls. I hope you enjoyed today's STEM program brought to you by the Toronto Public Library. Be sure to check back soon for more STEM programs at home. Thank you so much for watching, and bye for now.